Coming up on today's episode of Airborne Unlimited, Trans States Airlines rolls out $44,000 signing bonus for pilots. Sunna Pilot Lost January 3rd opens fundraiser. A new personal helicopter introduced by Scout Aero. Hello, I'm Laura Hudson. It's January 17th, and this is Airborne Unlimited. Trans States Airlines has announced a $44,000 signing bonus for new hire first officers. The new bonus includes an additional $6,000 bonus for pilots with a type rating. Total first-year compensation for new hire first officers will now approach $86,000. Pilots with airline experience who are hired as captain-qualified first officers can fly as a first officer or a captain, and can expect a minimum year one compensation package of up to $90,000, with the opportunity to earn even more when flying as a captain. Once on property, Trans States pilots can also earn referral and mentor bonuses. In addition to having one of the fastest captain upgrades in the regional airline industry, Trans States provides a number of unique opportunities, including a seniority reservation program that greatly reduces the likelihood of sitting reserve as a first officer, and an express hire program that allows current and qualified 121 pilots to forgo the interview process. Additionally, Trans States is one of the only airlines in the industry with immediate access to the left seat for qualified pilots. The aforementioned programs are effective immediately. After the break, Thrush Aircraft begins exploration of autonomous air tanker.
There's a difference between charting a steady course and pushing for the ceiling. And for nearly a century, Hartzell Propeller has been defining that difference. It's in our passion for engineering and research, and our dedication to testing the limits of performance. We are built on honor. We are Hartzell Propeller.
Sandia introduces the new SAI 340 Quattro TSO'd airspeed, attitude, altitude, and slip. With integral backup battery, safety never looked so good. See it now at www.sandia.aero.
The Bristell Light Sport Aircraft is what you are looking for. The Bristell is wider than a Cirrus, faster than a Skyhawk, offers more storage than a Husky, and comes standard with Garmin avionics. So what are you waiting for? Visit Bristell.com to find out how you can get into a Bristell today.
Welcome back. If you have a story suggestion for Airborne Unlimited, Aero TV, Airborne Unmanned, the AMA Drone Report, our website or podcast, just email to news-spy at aero-news.net. With so much news coming out of the aviation industry, we're summarizing some other interesting stories in a brief segment we call Around the Patch. Thrush Aircraft has formed a strategic alliance with highly regarded unmanned aerial vehicle and systems manufacturer Drone America to begin development of the world's first autonomous air tanker. The new tanker is expected to blend Thrush's large airframe and airborne delivery system expertise with Drone America's aerial amphibious platform, resulting in an aircraft capable of delivering some 800 gallons of water or fire retardant autonomously. A Pegasus Airlines 737-800 was involved in a runway excursion on Sunday and slid off a cliff, leaving it stuck in the mud a few feet above the Black Sea. The airplane overshot the runway and went over the edge, becoming stuck in the mud before impacting the water at the base of the cliff. There were 162 passengers and crew on board the airplane, and all were evacuated safely. Gamma is now taking applications for its prestigious Edward W. Stimson Aviation Excellence Award, which comes with a $2,000 cash prize. The award is named for founder and past president of Gamma, Edward W. Stimson. Given annually, the scholarship goes to a graduating high school senior who has been accepted to and will be enrolled in an aviation degree core program at a university or college of his or her choice. Rolls-Royce has announced that it is to operate a jet engine testbed at the Alliance Airport in Fort Worth, Texas. The company has signed a lease to take over the entire 440,000-square-foot former Texas Aero Engine Services facility, of which the testbed is a part of. The testbed will be used to carry out endurance test runs for Rolls-Royce Trent engines, allowing the company to continue to support its growing fleet at a time of unprecedented activity. Well, that's it for today's Shipper on the Patch. Now let's move on to the rest of the news. Earlier this month, a Cirrus SR-22T airplane on a flight plan from Oklahoma City, Oklahoma to Georgetown, Texas, continued over the Gulf of Mexico before finally coming down in the Gulf north of Cancun, Mexico. The pilot apparently lost consciousness, and the plane flew on autopilot until its fuel was exhausted. Now, the son of that pilot, whose name was Bill Kinsinger, has launched a GoFundMe campaign in an effort to raise enough money to go locate the airplane and his dad's remains. "My dad, Bill Kinsinger, was one of the most exceptional men that has ever been put on this earth, impacting every single person he came across in a positive way," Jake Kinsinger wrote on the GoFundMe page. The Coast Guard has suspended search efforts as they don't do underwater searches. "I have decided the best response is to do what they wouldn't and go out to the waters dragging a sonar to tell me what it looks like under the surface and recover his plane and give him a proper burial where he wished." After these messages, a new personal helicopter introduced by Scout Aero.
In collaboration with NASC, introducing Sonics Aerospace, bringing you the Taros Group 4 UAS, the redesigned Tiger Shark Block 4, and the Subsonics Twin Jet UAS, all derived from flight-proven manned systems, not concepts, real aircraft. More at sonicsaerospace.com.
Welcome back. A new aircraft is always big news for the GA market, but a new rotorcraft is even more noteworthy. A new three-place civilian helicopter has been introduced by Scout Aero of Coatesville, Pennsylvania, that is being marketed as a personal aircraft that is ready to fly at $195,000. According to the company website, the Scout has a range of 310 nautical miles cruising at 95 knots, equaling a 3.2-hour endurance. The service ceiling of the aircraft is listed at over 20,000 feet. A pilot and two passengers are seated three abreast in the cockpit. The aircraft is equipped with landing gear as well as passengers and pilot seat absorb system. Scout successfully passed through all relevant crash tests, the company says. The helicopter is powered by a 210-horsepower Lycoming engine. It has an empty weight of 993 pounds and a maximum takeoff weight of 1,950 pounds. Well, that's our program for today. Remember that Airborne Unlimited is currently on our winter schedule and is streamed Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, alternating with Airborne Unmanned on Tuesday and the AMA Drone Report each Thursday. Additional breaking news bulletins may be posted for important stories that fall outside of our normal deadlines. If you're watching us on YouTube, please subscribe and do check us out on Facebook and Twitter. Get comprehensive, real-time, 24/7 coverage of the latest aviation and aerospace stories anytime at aero-news.net. See you tomorrow.